Glad you're back. Let's review. After his mother died, Santos was left with no means to survive. Except that one time when his cousin said,
"Vamos a robar."
But Santos refused to turn to crime, so he prayed for a miracle. Meanwhile, Pipe had become popular with the ladies. And he became skilled in the art of drowning your sorrows. But all this was about to change. I know what you are thinking. How did things change for Santos and Pipe? Well, my friends, you have waited long enough.
Allí me dijo la extranjera. Me quería larga.
Lars, it is a countercultural movement that began in France and spread to a few other places. Santos and Pipe helped build their home and a workplace. Pipe began planting beans again, and Santos learned the art of weaving hammocks. They advocated for their rights on the radio and in the streets. They made peace with the past. The years went by. Birthdays, holidays, funerals.
Yo tengo 30 años con Felipe de estar aquí. Yo me siento feliz de la vida.
And now we've reached the unremarkable encounter of Santos and Yanila. It was just another morning. Santos had fetched the tortillas. Pipe had said his morning prayers. And after praying, time for a riddle.
¿Qué le dijo el ojo al otro? Tan cerca que estamos y no las miramos.
Te amo.
Te amo. No, tan cerca que estamos y no las miramos.
That same day, Santos agreed to do an interview. Remember that baby? She was the translator. And though Yanila lived near Santos and ate chilaquiles at the same taqueria, she had never met Santos Osorto. The interview began, and Yanila translated every word, but then she stopped. Santos had been describing the very moment his mother left. Remember when he said,
"Está bien, mamá. Váyase en paz."
The truth was that in his heart, he wanted to say,
"¿Por qué me puede llevar usted también?"
Yanila knew the translation, but she couldn't say those words.
No llore. No. No. No llore, hombre.
Now here's the moral to this very long and confusing story. Remember Santos's riddle?
Tan cerca que estamos y no lo miramos.
I repeat. We are so close, but we never see each other. Like a bully who saw a cripple and not a cowboy. Like a father who saw a mistake and not a son. And like Yanila who saw a man who struggled, whose life had nothing in common with her own. Now what made Yanila cry? 10 years ago, her mother left Honduras and has been working in the United States ever since. Due to immigration politics, she has not been able to return. Not for Yanila's quinceañera, not Christmas, not even for her graduation. So Santos's words, "Why can't I go with you?" were the very same words in Yanila's heart. And just like that, it happened. The unremarkable encounter of Santos and Yanila. They seemed so different, but in the end, they had more in common than they thought. Wait, why the long face? You wanted Yanila to be his long-lost sister? What do you think this is, a telenovela? Let me remind you, I've always said it would be very, very unremarkable. I can't just leave you like that. Think about it. Why, after such a sensational story, would we end with something so anticlimactic? Why did Omar teach Santos to make hammocks? An unremarkable encounter. And how they got on the radio? An unremarkable encounter. And why Santos spent the past 30 years helping to build this? You get the picture. These encounters might not change everything, but it's up to you if they'll change anything.
Okay, espero que ya está.